رمضان زمان البركات رمضان زمان الحسنات رمضان زمان البركات رمضان زمان الحسنات رمضان مجال الصلوات رمضان مجال الصلوات طوبى للنفس بتقواها طوبى للنفس بتقواها.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
سبح اسم ربك الأعلى.
سبح اسم ربك الأعلى.
الذي خلق فسوى.
الذي خلق فسوى.
والذي قدر فهدى.
والذي قدر فهدى.
والذي أخرج المرعى.
والذي أخرج المرعى.
فجعله غثاء أحوى.
فجعله غثاء أحوى.
سنقرئك فلا تنسى.
سنقرئك فلا تنسى.
إلا ما شاء الله.
إلا ما شاء الله.
إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى.
إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى.
ونيسرك لليسرى.
ونيسرك لليسرى.
فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى.
فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى.
سيذكر من يخشى.
سيذكر من يخشى.
ويتجنبها الأشقى.
ويتجنبها الأشقى.
الذي يصلى النار الكبرى.
الذي يصلى النار الكبرى.
ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا.
ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا.
قد أفلح من تزكى.
قد أفلح من تزكى.
وذكر اسم ربه فصلى.
وذكر اسم ربه فصلى.
بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا.
بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا.
والآخرة خير وأبقى.
والآخرة خير وأبقى.
إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى.
إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى.
صحف إبراهيم وموسى
صحف إبراهيم وموسى
صدق الله العظيم
صدق الله العظيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. In today's lesson, we are going to be covering the first letter of our lessons, inshallah, and it's the letter Hamza. The letter Hamza emerges from the deepest part of our throat. It's something that comes from the lowest part of our throat, and it's pronounced saying a, a, e, e, and u, u. That's how you pronounce the letter Hamza. Now, what happens sometimes when we're pronouncing the letter Hamza in certain words, especially when it's surrounded by letters that have a heavier characteristic than it normally does, we end up making the sound of the Hamza heavier than it should be. An example of this is in the word al-sabi'ahum. What happens is, because of the heaviness of the sad after the Hamza, people say asa, asabi'ahum, right? And so what we have to ensure is that the Hamza is pronounced with lightness. A, asabi'ahum. And what a good tip is for you to take on and to remember at all times is that if you're ever confused about how a letter should be pronounced in a combination with other letters, always go back to how it sounds on its own. Hamza sounds like a, e, and u. A, e, and u. Another issue that happens is, and it's a very common word in the Quran that we come across, ya ayyuha. What happens is people say, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ya ayyuha nasu. They kind of just rush over the Hamza, they skip over the Hamza. The correct pronunciation, and everyone should be cognizant of it when this word shows up, is that you say, ya ayyuhalladhina, ya ayyuhannas. Notice how I'm clearly articulating it as opposed to rushing through it and saying it in a manner that completely eliminates the sound of the Hamza. And the final point that I'll mention about the letter Hamza is that this letter, when you stop on it, so let's say I'm saying the word as-samaa, and I stop on the word, and you run out of breath, for example, or it's at the end of an ayah and you stop, people sometimes will take away the sound. They'll just say, as-samaa. Notice how you didn't hear the Hamza from my throat come out at all. So what we have to ensure that we do is say, as-samaa, as-samaa. And you add a little bit of emphasis at the end to show and to let the listener know and to recite properly and indicate that there is a Hamza present. And so this is the first letter that we'll cover. It's the Hamza from the throat. And as we go on throughout these lessons, we are going to be covering each of the letters in chronological order. So we will go from the deepest part of our throat all the way outwards. So look forward to the next lesson where we'll be covering the next closest letter to the Hamza, that being the Ha. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahumma laka sumt, wa ala rizqika aftart. Allahumma inni as'aluka bi rahmatik, allati wasi'at kulla shay'. أن تغفر لي ذنوبي. ذهب الظمأ وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله.
رمضان زمان البركات رمضان زمان الحسنات رمضان زمان